Soft capture confirmed.
That's the softest stocking I've ever had.
All smiles.
A successful launch and now a successful deboarding for the Axiom 2 crew members. After about 18 hours, the crew is finally at the International Space Station. WestJet's Tony Atkins has been tracking their historic journey as the real work sets to begin.
And we have our first views of the Axiom crew members floating aboard. First is Commander Peggy Watson.
A warm, low-gravity welcome for the AX-2 crew members. Astronauts greeting the crew with hugs, photos, and handshakes as they floated their way into the International Space Station. The crew finally out and ready to begin work aboard the ISS. Before this, though, 18 hours in orbit, roughly about the time that it takes to fly direct from Orlando to Dubai.
Well, this moment is historic, not just for me, but for every Saudi. And I couldn't have done it without the support, the love, the trust from all of you guys.
The crew had time on their mission to send back a video message about their experiences.
It's pretty amazing. You know, to describe the feeling when the second stage kicks the Dragon off into orbit, you realize instantly you're weightless. And it's just an amazing feeling.
Now, this group includes three paying passengers, two from Saudi Arabia's space agency, as well as an American aviator who acted as a pilot on the mission.
To the people around the world, well, the future is very bright, and I would like you to dream big, believe in yourselves, and believe in humanity.
The trip was commanded by American Peggy Watson, who's now the first woman to command an all-commercial mission to the International Space Station. She's adding on to 655 days lived in space.
I'm really excited about returning to space, but even more excited about welcoming three new astronauts to space, plus Gigi's here with us in her little Axiom spacesuit.
And while in space, the group will work on more than 20 experiments. Things like space radiation and weather conditions in low gravity. Axiom says it plans to use these commercial launches to build experiences with partners like SpaceX and NASA. The company also adds it's working toward building its own and the first commercial space station, as the International Space Station is set to retire in 2030. Reporting in Orlando, Tony Atkins, WestJet 2 News.